woman, Latinx owned children's bookstore. It is our honor to be a part of the South Wedge community. It is our honor to be a part of the child community, the young adult community, and communities throughout the city of Rochester and the region. We have today with us some very important people. Our youngest author is back here. We have a recently published author here. And we have our own Leslie Youngblood, Love Like Sky, here. And Leslie's book is sitting atop that there. Maybe Leslie can show it out to the group. And she's now working on a second coming up. Okay. Right, Leslie?
Yes.
Awesome.
So, June 2020.
Yes. So anybody that would like to chat with any one of our authors, we have Hassan from the neighborhood Fountain of Youth Center, where Hassan has been with us now since we started, and we're looking at collaboration. Everything for us is literature. Everything is literature based. We have Javier from Canandaigua National Bank, who has been with us. We have others who I know forever, Daisy. I won't say how long, but forever. And all of you now are part of what I consider our Hipocampo family. Hipocampo is a region of the brain for emotional knowledge. Hipocampo in the Greek mythological realm is a seahorse. Hipocampo, for me, in the South Bronx, growing up, was the most active salsa dance nightclub there was in the Bronx during the late 70s and 80s. It has three meanings for me, right? So anyone who tells you what's Hipocampo about, feel free to take one of our cards, and on the back it explains it. But Hipocampo is also, for Pamela and I, a passion. A passion. We are passionate about what we're doing here. We are highlighting the languages of our city, of our communities. We have books in 12 different languages, and it's grown. We want our children to come in here and see themselves on the cover of a book. And we've had that already. A mom the other day said, I'm getting emotional. I haven't been in a place where I saw myself in so many books. Or a little girl was here with her grandmother. Grandma, grandma, she looks just like me. And it was the cover of, we want that to be repeated. And then we want all our children, regardless of your language or your culture, to come here and learn. Learn from the power of literature, from the power of being together in a learning environment. So I can go on and on and on. 34 years being a kindergarten teacher, I can talk about the research, I can talk about the social economic value, I can go in a lot of directions. But as Hipocampo Children's Bookstore, this has been an act of love by this community. This was a tattoo parlor. The walls were red and black. Can you imagine how many coats it took to cover to get to that blue? There were stalls this high. We repurposed them. Pauli Colon came in here and we tore this down and repurposed it and made this and made shelves that are hidden in the background. You can see the outline of the shelves behind Mitch. They go up and then they go up that wall. That mural was MJ. MJ is an RIT animations professor. She said, I've done murals before. I got an idea. Let me do the mural for you. MJ drew that mural. Then Brian said, well, you know what? I can create little areas to slip the books in. Brian did that. And then Yanni and Yimi and Aaron and Sarah came in and they spent hours painting. I mean, it goes on and on and on. The kind of community support we've had. And we're honored to be there, because that shows us that in the 5 weeks that we've been here, whoa. You know, and we're not naive. This is a marathon. This is not a 100-yard dash. this has its ups and downs. When we created our business plan, we looked at the analytics. We looked at the trends. We looked at how things are fluctuating in the market. We looked at so many aspects of what we were going to do. We did not pursue this from a sort of like, you know, totally passion-based somewhat. No, we were critically aware of what we were going for. And I'll tell you, there's one thing. Never tell a kindergarten teacher you can't do something. Because we create miracles every day for 185 days of an academic year. Right.